So Mohawk Industries, we are your largest flooring company, so feel free to see me if you need carpet, tile, rugs, hardwood, laminate. I can get you set up. So Mohawk is global, and if you know anything about Mohawk, Mohawk's really grown by acquisitions over the years. Our corporate office actually is in Calhoun, so you get up 75 and drive 60 miles, and there you are, in the middle of carpet capital. So you can see Mohawk is a global organization, but our biggest footprint really is in Northwest Georgia because that's where it all came together. So we do have a strong mission around sustainability. We are one of the largest recyclers of plastic bottles, like what Barbara has right there that goes into carpet products. And we've also taken that sustainability kind of approach with our healthcare plan. And so I think what's important to know, for all of us, while it's different, there are common themes, and it also is a journey. Today, when people want a quick fix and you're worried about this year's budget and next year's budget, you also have to remember where you've been and where you ultimately want to get to, because it does take a minute. So for Mohawk, our strategy takes some of these parts. We've been very lucky, and we're proud of the fact that we've had about a 2% trend year over year since 2009. And one of our biggest focuses is not only on what the company spends, but what the employee spends, because we have to make sure that our healthcare is affordable for our employees and their families. So when we look at it, our primary focus, our vision has really been to have the healthiest and safest workforce in industry. And so not the carpet industry, not manufacturing, just in industry. And everything we do ties back to, are we driving that initiative? As we go back and we look at where we've been, where we are, and where we expect to go, you can see by our footprint in Northwest Georgia, half of our population in the U.S. really reside from Cartersville through Dalton, with some smattering in Chattanooga. So we really have the ability with that 7,500 employee count to be able to do something. And so for us, that equates to about 15,000 members. So what we do in Northwest Georgia has really started to cascade across the rest of the country. So what is that? So similarly to Lisa and Barbara, we've put on-site clinics. So we don't have one. We have about 24. They're all embedded in our plants. So the convenience factor, we believe, is one of the biggest differences. We do allow employees to go during their work schedule, which has not always been an easy path to navigate with plant managers who have, you know, the mission in life to get the work done. But if it's not easy and it's not convenient, to your comment, right, people are just less resistant to go. They don't make the time. We have, like I said, about 24 on-site clinics. They are managed and staffed by Cigna, who is our partner. So they have evolved a great deal in the last 8 years. They are staffed by mid-levels, oversight by a physician. There is not a pharmacy connected with this team. We use a traditional PBM, but we do have some fairly aggressive plan design components that we had to deploy after 2014, when specialty pharmacy spend was like 48%. So that was an interesting time, but we have that under control at this point, so we're not too worried about pharmacy. We do provide preventative services, diabetic supplies, all that kind of good stuff at no cost to the member. So we don't want to hear that cost is an impediment to being compliant, which is a huge initiative for us. Mohawk has adopted a high deductible plan. We've had that since 2012. We like to say we have one choice, and that's our health plan. You can choose to participate or not. So the good news is most people do. We have about 80% participation. We've always had about 80% of our employees participate in the health plan, back from when it was a PPO through, I think, in the summer when we pulled the most recent participation numbers. So in our clinics, we drive a lot of activity. They've been a traditional kind of come in, treat the symptom, go back to work, go back home, wherever it is. Now we are really trying to deploy a model of a care team. So Mohawk has a philosophy that you have to get your biometrics. We do it every 2 years. And we encourage you to do that, you and your spouse. You can certainly choose not to, but it does cost you more to make that choice. So we have about 97% participation of our employees that get their biometrics and their spouses. And then that really drives the outreach from the clinic team so that we can actively engage you as the employer or the spouse to end up in a better health spot. Because if we can get you better educated, if we can get you pharmacy compliant, if we can help you manage and understand what's going on, you are going to spend less. Certainly Mohawk hopes to spend less, but from an employee out-of-pocket perspective, that's significant. So part of how all that is done, to Barbara's point, is about data. So we have wrestled with this issue, I think like every other employer, right? We're not unique. But how you get it, what you do with it, what's your responsibility, how you balance HIPAA, how you balance trying to get to the employee who really doesn't get it, right? They're not interested. They've always felt this way. This is how their parents were. It runs in their family. It's just a fact of life. And to try to be impactful to that really can change somebody's, literally their life. And so that's really part of our big driver. Everything we do goes to this vision. But really, our ultimate objective is we want every employee to be self-managed. We want them to understand where they are and understand what they need to do and then do it. So for us, it really comes down to that. So some of the other things we're doing as we've moved along our clinics to become what we call a care team. So we want to surround those people who need the most help with the most services. We want to put it in your way. We want to make it hard for you to say, no, thank you. So we spend a lot of time and effort. We have an extensive team through Cigna of coaches, providers, care advocates, case managers, I'm leaving out, referral coordinators. So this is all accessible for the member, and it can be steered through the clinic. It can be steered through your local local physician. And as we look into 15, 16, 17, and 18 then, we really became strong believers that this whole notion of care coordination, right? It's not unique. We didn't think it up. But how it gets deployed and how people know how to navigate, because let's face it, most people have no experience in how to navigate through the healthcare system until they're in the middle of it. And then it's emotional, it's expensive, it involves themselves or a family member. So a great big swirl starts. So as we look to evolve and what we can do through our clinics and now these care teams, and we want to get it everywhere. So part of how we're doing it specifically in Northwest Georgia, we worked with our Cigna as our partner. They weren't able to really build the system that we wanted, so we've done it ourselves. So we steered through plan design for the last 3 years, from 15 to 17, 1-1-18, the approach Mohawk is taking in Northwest Georgia from about Cartersville through Chattanooga is we're building our own custom network, which we swore we'd never do, but here we are. And so we are not owners of the contracts. We did hire a network partner to do that. But the most important thing is we are asking all of the providers that are in the network to clinically connect their data. So we want to know and have the clinic team and your physician know everything about you. So that experience when you go in and your physician says, so what medications are you taking? And you're like, well, I'm not sure. I think I'm taking this and this, and they don't have your list, and you forget. And all of a sudden, they don't have the full picture. And so part of our objective is in this clinically integrated delivery system, we want the physician to know everything they can know about you so they can manage you holistically and then help drive this care coordination path, right? Everybody knows the PT story. You go for surgery, you have surgery, you go for two PT visits, it's too expensive, you quit going, you think you can do it at home, and now you've got a whole another set of issues later on. So we're also trying to deploy bundled payments to hold everybody accountable, the employee and the provider, to seek that full continuum of care. So I don't know if I'm out of time.
Right.
Okay. So I think for us, this custom network, and I'll make I probably shouldn't make a commercial, but I will. So the intent of Mohawk building this network is not that it's just for Mohawk. Our intent really for it to be sustainable in Northwest Georgia is we need other employers to join in so that we can really try to be impactful to the overall experience for the folks who live in this area, And so, you know, plan design what your resource will be custom to the different employers, but we know we need them if we're going to really make this a viable entity. So for us, that's what we're driving towards.